Hello everyone, this class is presented to you by Didymi IAS. This class is for beginners who have just started their preparations for the civil services exam. In this class, we will be covering chapter 2 of class 11 NCERT Indian Constitution at Work. So first of all, let's see the index of this book. So in total, there are 10 chapters. And today we will be covering chapter 2, which is Rights in the Indian Constitution. So after studying this chapter, you would know what are the various fundamental rights listed in the Constitution of India, how these rights are protected, what role the judiciary has played in protecting and interpreting these rights, what is the difference between the fundamental rights and the directive principles of state policy? So these are the broad topics that we will cover in this chapter. We will study what fundamental rights are. We will study the responsibility of the judiciary in protecting and interpreting these fundamental rights. And besides fundamental rights, we will also see what are directive principles. So this is all that we will be covering in this chapter. So this is the image showing all the six fundamental rights that we will cover. So there are six fundamental rights: right to equality, right to freedom, right against exploitation, right to freedom of religion, cultural and educational rights, and right to constitutional remedies. But before beginning with these rights, first of all, we should know why do we call these rights as fundamental rights. So you must know that the meaning of the word fundamental is essential, zaruri. So what is so essential about these rights? How are these rights different from the other ordinary legal rights? Why these rights are so fundamental as compared to the other ordinary rights? So these rights are fundamental because these rights are separately listed by the Constitution in Part 3, and also the Constitution has made special provisions for their protection. That means the protection of fundamental rights is taken care of by the Constitution itself. The Constitution has not left it on the legislature to take care of these rights. The Constitution itself has listed provisions. The Constitution has not asked the legislature to make provisions regarding the protection of fundamental rights. No. In fact, the Constitution itself has listed how these fundamental rights can be protected. The Constitution has also given the responsibility, the duty to the judiciary to see whether the fundamental rights are violated by legislature or executive or not. So all the provisions regarding their protection, these fundamental rights being separately listed, these provisions make these rights fundamental in nature. Whereas if we see the other ordinary rights, for example, right to property, it is an ordinary legal right. The legislature takes care, you know, everything related to that right. Legislature makes provisions, legislature can amend this right as and when is required and according to the wishes of the legislature. But in case of fundamental rights, these fundamental rights cannot be amended by the legislature. So that is why we call these rights as fundamental rights. Now, ordinary legal rights are protected and enforced by the ordinary law, whereas fundamental rights are protected and guaranteed by the Constitution of the country. Ordinary rights may be changed by the legislature by ordinary process of lawmaking, whereas fundamental rights may only be changed by amending the Constitution itself. Now, already discussed, judiciary has the powers and responsibility to protect the fundamental rights. And while protecting these fundamental rights, if the judiciary finds that any of the executive or legislative actions are illegal, so judiciary can declare those actions as illegal. Judiciary can restrain those actions. Judiciary can tell that these actions are unreasonable. So such is the responsibility of the judiciary. But at the same time, these fundamental rights are not absolute or unlimited rights. Absolute ka matlab hota hai ki koi limit hi nahi hai unke upar. But these fundamental rights, they are not absolute. There are some limits on these rights, and these limits we will study in the upcoming slides. So first right is right to equality. Now under this right, there are Article 14, Article 15, 16, 17, and 18. So there are five articles under right to equality. So first of all, Article 14. So Article 14 states that state shall not deny to any person equality before law or equal protection of laws. So in order to understand Article 14, we need to understand what is equality before law and what is equal protection of laws. So first, equality before law. Equality before law ka matlab hai, law ke aage sare barabar hai. That means law is the king. Nobody is above the law. So equality before law states that law सबसे ऊपर है and law के नीचे सारे हैं and everybody is equal. Everybody is equal in the eyes of law. So there is rule of law. There is equality before law. Next is equal protection of laws. Now equal protection of laws states that it says that सबके circumstances different होते हैं. So because the circumstances are different, so people with different circumstances cannot be treated similarly. People with different circumstances need to be treated in a different manner. For example, income tax. Jin logon ki income kam hoti hai, they pay less income tax. Jin ki income bahut zyada hoti hai, they pay more income tax. So, kyunki jiski kam income hai, unke circumstances different hai. जिसकी ज्यादा इनकम है उसके सर्कमस्टांसेस डिफरेंट है, तो इक्वल प्रोटेक्शन ऑफ लॉज के अकॉर्डिंग उनको सिमिलरली ट्रीट नहीं किया जा सकता, बिकॉज द सिचुएशन इज डिफरेंट, द सर्कमस्टांसेस आर डिफरेंट. दैट इज व्हाई द इनकम टैक्स दैट इज पेड बाय बोथ दीज टाइप्स ऑफ पीपल इट इज डिफरेंट. सो इक्वल प्रोटेक्शन ऑफ लॉज इट स्टेट्स दैट people who are not in similar circumstances, they cannot be treated similarly. There needs to be separate provisions for these people who are living under different circumstances. So basically equal protection of laws states that there can be some reasonable discrimination. So this is equal protection of laws and equality before law. नेक्स्ट इज आर्टिकल 15. आर्टिकल 15 कहता है कि जो भी पब्लिक प्लेसेस हैं, जैसे कि शॉप्स, होटल्स, प्लेसेस ऑफ एंटरटेनमेंट, वेल्स, बेदिंग घाट्स एंड प्लेसेस ऑफ वर्शिप, इन पब्लिक प्लेसेस पे कोई भी जा सकता है. देयर कैन बी नो डिस्क्रिमिनेशन ऑन द ग्राउंड्स ऑफ रिलीजन, रेस, कास्ट, सेक्स और प्लेस ऑफ बर्थ. सो दीज पब्लिक प्लेसेस कैन बी विजिटेड बाय एनीबॉडी एंड देयर शैल बी नो डिस्क्रिमिनेशन. अब इन द एंशिएंट टाइम्स यू मस्ट हैव हर्ड दैट जो वेल्स होते थे, जो लोअर कास्ट के पीपल होते थे, दे वर नॉट अलाउड टू यूज दोज वेल्स. Or the recent issue, the Sabarimala temple issue. The issue is that women cannot visit the temple, place of worship. Discrimination is being done on the ground of sex. So these kind of discriminations is prohibited by Article 15. Now Article 16. Article 16 prohibits any discrimination in public employment. Article 16 states that under public employment there cannot be any discrimination. That means everybody is allowed to hold a public office and there shall be no discrimination. Next is Article Article 18 states that the state shall not confer any title. Up again, in the ancient time, many titles used to exist, right? Like the Rao Bahadur, Rao Sahab. So these kind of titles used to exist. So those kind of titles are abolished by Article 18. But at the same time, there was one controversy that awards like Bharat Ratna, it was said that these awards, they violate Article 18. They said these also constitute titles. So these awards should be abolished. But then it was cleared by the judiciary that these titles or these awards, they are given to people who excel in military or academic fields. So they are given these awards for their distinguished services. So under Article 18, state shall not confer any title except those who excel themselves in military or academic fields. So this is Article 18. Now Article 17 was left. So Article 17 abolishes untouchability. Again, Purane Zamane mein untouchability used to exist. The untouchability is chua chhat ki bimari. Jaise ki if any Dalit person, he has touched something, then the person from the upper caste, they say wo us cheez ko touch nahi karte the, kyunki it was said that a lower caste or a Dalit person has touched it, so upper caste ke jo log the wo us cheez ko touch nahi karte the, that was untouchability. So Article 17, it abolishes untouchability. अब बहुत बार डायरेक्ट क्वेश्चन आ जाता है दैट विच आर्टिकल अबॉलिशेस अनटचेबिलिटी. सो द आंसर इज आर्टिकल 17. नाउ इन आर्टिकल 16 वी सेड दैट पब्लिक एम्प्लॉयमेंट में देयर शैल बी नो डिस्क्रिमिनेशन. दैट मींस अ पब्लिक ऑफिस कैन बी हेल्ड बाय एनीबॉडी एंड देयर शैल बी नो डिस्क्रिमिनेशन ऑन एनी ग्राउंड. बट एट द सेम टाइम वी सी दैट देयर इज रिजर्वेशन. कुछ लोगों को कुछ सीट्स रिजर्व्ड होती हैं. एवरीबडी नोज अबाउट रिजर्वेशन. सो इज रिजर्वेशन वायलेटिव ऑफ आर्टिकल 16? नो, बिकॉज रिजर्वेशन इट इज नॉट अ वायलेशन. इन फैक्ट इट फुलफिल्स द spirit of constitution. Our constitution says that there should be equality of opportunity for everyone. So some people, they are given this reservation so that they can reach this equality. They can also, they fulfill what is required under a right to equality. So reservation, under reservation, we try to give opportunity to every section of society. And that is why reservation is done for certain backward classes who are educationally or socially backward classes. So certain seats are reserved for them. So reservation shall not be seen as a violation of right to equality. In fact, this reservation, it fulfills the essence of right to equality. So right to equality strives to make India a true democracy by ensuring a sense of equality of dignity and status among all its citizens. So this was about right to equality. Article 14, it states that the state shall not deny equality before law and equal protection of laws. Article 15, public places, everybody can access, have access to these public places and there shall be no discrimination. Article 16, no discrimination in public employment. Article 17, it abolishes untouchability. And Article 18, it states that the state shall confer no title. So this was the first right to equality. Now, next right is right to freedom. Under this right, we discuss Article 19, 20, 21, and 22. So first of all, right to Article 19. So under this right, we have been given six types of freedoms. The first freedom is freedom of thought, expression, and action. So it means that we have a freedom to have our own thoughts and also we have a freedom to express those thoughts. Jaise ki social media pe today, if anybody is not satisfied with any policy of the government, so they have full freedom to express their views on that policy. Social media pe people criticize as well, and also they appreciate also the policies of the government. So they are expressing their views on that policy. So we have this freedom. We have been given this freedom under Article 19. But at the same time, this freedom should be exercised without threatening the freedom of others. Next freedom under Article 19 is freedom to assemble peacefully and without arms. That means kahin pe bhi we can assemble, but that assembly should be peaceful and also it should be without arms. Next is freedom to form associations or unions. We see many kind of unions, jaise ki kisan union. So you have a freedom under Article 19 to form associations or unions. Next is freedom to move freely throughout the territory of India. Next is freedom to reside and settle in any part of the territory of India. Next is freedom to practice any profession or occupation. So this is right to freedom. You have freedom of thought and expression. You can assemble anywhere. You have freedom to assemble, but it should be peaceful and without arms. Next, you have a freedom to form associations or unions. You have a freedom to move freely throughout the territory of India. You can reside and settle in any part of the territory of India, and you can practice any profession or occupation. So these are the six types of freedoms that are provided under Article 19. Next is Article 20, protection with respect to conviction of offenses. Now, before discussing this article, there are two words, conviction and convict and acquit. So, do tarah ke words hai. Ab acquit kya hota hai? Suppose किसी पर्सन के ऊपर कोई चार्जेस लगे हैं, सपोज मर्डर के चार्जेस लगे हैं, अब इन केस वो चार्जेस प्रूव हो जाते हैं, देन दैट पर्सन बिकम्स अ कन्विक्ट. अगर प्रूव हो जाता है कि उसने मर्डर किया है तो उसको जेल होएगी, फाइन लगेगा, सो दैट पर्सन बिकम्स अ कन्विक्ट. बट इन केस वो प्रूव नहीं हो जाता एंड दैट पर्सन ही इज सेट फ्री, उसको बरी कर दिया जाता है, then that person is acquitted. That is called acquit. So convict as well as acquit. So these are the two words. Now in this Article 20, जो convicts होते हैं, उनकी protection को लेके जो भी rights हैं, that we will cover in this Article 20. So protection with respect to conviction of offences. The first right under this is no person would be punished for the same offense more than once. So, agar kisi ne koi bhi offense kiya hai, suppose murder kiya hai, ab us murder ke liye, that very murder, for that murder he can be punished only once. He cannot be punished twice. This is the first right. This is also called no double jeopardy. Next is no law shall declare any action as illegal from a backdate. So for example, aaj ke time pe chori karna illegal nahi hai. So aapne aaj chori kari, but next year chori ko illegal offense bana diya jata hai. But aapne chori jab ki thi us time pe it was not an illegal offense. So jis din next year jab usko illegal offense banaya gaya hai, तब से अगर कोई चोरी करेगा, only then that person can be punished. Law बनने से पहले अगर किसी ने वो काम किया, कोई offence, वो offence किया, तो that person cannot be punished. This is that no action can be declared as illegal from back date. This is also called no ex post facto legislation. Next is no person shall be asked to give evidence against himself or herself. किसी भी convict को force नहीं किया जा सकता to give evidence against himself or herself. You cannot force that person. But at the same time, किसी भी उस convict को अगर urine sample या blood sample देने के लिए बोला गया है, that does not come under this. That is not considered as giving evidence. So blood sample or urine sample वो तो देना ही पड़ेगा. That is not under this article. So दूसरे तरह के जो एविडेंस होते हैं वो देने के लिए किसी भी कन्विक्ट को फोर्स नहीं किया जा सकता. सो दीज आर द थ्री राइट्स, नो डबल जेओपार्डी, नो एक्स पोस्ट फैक्टो लेजिस्लेशन एंड नो गिविंग ऑफ एविडेंस अगेंस्ट हिमसेल्फ और हरसेल्फ. नेक्स्ट इज आर्टिकल 21 विच इज राइट टू लाइफ एंड पर्सनल लिबर्टी. Now, this Article 21, it states that no person shall be denied his life or personal liberty except as a procedure laid down under the law. In order to understand this article, we need to understand the term life, personal liberty, and procedure established by law. So, first of all, let's see personal liberty. अब personal liberty का मतलब होता है कि liberty का मतलब होता है you are free. You are free to do anything. You are free to roam anywhere. Now, this liberty, it can be restrained by arresting you or by detaining you. आपकी liberty चली जाएगी अब अगर आपको arrest कर लिया जाए या फिर आपको detain करके रख लिया जाए. Now, under this article, personal liberty can be taken away. That means you can be arrested or detained, but it has to be done according to the procedure that has been laid down under the law. That means arrest ke jo bhi provisions hai ki aise arrest hoega, by following those provisions only you can be arrested. By following those provisions only your personal liberty can be taken away. But if that procedure is not followed, then that will be violation of Article 21. So this is personal liberty and procedure established by law. Now the term life. This term has been described or it has been, the scope of this right has been expanded by the Supreme Court in various cases. The Supreme Court said that the rights like right to have a healthy environment or right to have a shelter or right to have shelter. वो कहते हैं these things also come under life. That means life का मतलब ये नहीं है कि you know mere ability to survive. That is not called life. Life means having a dignified life. Life means having a clean environment. Life means having a proper shelter. Right means you are even getting, if you are not even getting food to eat, that is also not having the life. So life does not mean mere existing. You know, mere survival is not right to life. Right to life includes many things. So this, the term life has been expanded. The scope of this term has been expanded by the court. The Supreme Court has ruled that this right also includes right to live with human dignity, that is free from exploitation. Right to shelter and livelihood. This is also included under right to life. Now, we said that a person can only be arrested if he has done something. Agar humne waisa nahi kiya, procedure follow nahi kiya, toh that will be violation of Article 21. But many times, there is this term called preventive detention. Iska matlab ye hota hai ki agar पुलिस को शक है किसी पर्सन के ऊपर दैट दिस पर्सन ही इज अ थ्रेट टू लॉ एंड ऑर्डर और दिस पर्सन विल कमिट सम इलीगल ऑफेंस, अगर पुलिस को पहले से पता है देन दैट पर्सन कैन बी डिटेन्ड, दैट पर्सन कैन बी अरेस्टेड. दैट मीन्स अ पर्सन कैन बी अरेस्टेड सिंपली आउट ऑफ मेयर एप्रीहेंशन. तो एक सिर्फ शक के ऊपर, इस शक के ऊपर दैट ही इज लाइकली टू एंगेज इन सम अनलॉफुल एक्टिविटी, तो इस एप्रीहेंशन के बेस पे अ पर्सन कैन बी डिटेन्ड, अ पर्सन कैन बी इम्प्रिजन्ड. दिस इज कॉल्ड प्रिवेंटिव डिटेंशन. But this preventive detention, it can be extended only for 3 months, and after 3 months, such case has to be brought before the advisory board for review. Next is Article 22, protection against arrest and detention. Article 20 में हमने पढ़ा था कि जो भी convicts होते हैं, उनके लिए क्या-क्या protections हैं? इसमें in Article 22 अरेस्ट को लेके क्या क्या प्रोटेक्शंस है, अरेस्ट किन ग्राउंड्स पे हो सकती है, डिटेंशन को लेके क्या क्या प्रोटेक्शंस है, दैट आर लिस्टेड अंडर आर्टिकल 22. सो दिस आर्टिकल इट टेंड्स टू प्रिवेंट arbitrary arrest and detention. So this article states that if a police is arresting anybody, then they are bound to tell the grounds for such an arrest. If anybody is being arrested, किन grounds पे उसको arrest किया जा रहा है, that shall be told. तो ये बताना जरूरी होता है that what are the grounds for the arrest. Next is, if anybody is arrested, that arrested person has the right to defend himself by a lawyer of his choice. So, agar kisi ko arrest kiya jata hai, to uske paas right hai that he can have a lawyer of his own choice. Next, if when anybody is arrested, that arrested person has to be brought before the nearest magistrate within 24 hours. अब आर्टिकल 21 में हमने पढ़ा था कि पर्सनल लिबर्टी ली जा सकती है किसी की, बट ओनली अकॉर्डिंग टू द प्रोसीजर एस्टैब्लिश्ड बाय लॉ. तो अगर किसी को अरेस्ट किया जाता है, सो दीज ग्राउंड्स और दीज प्रोविजंस शुड बी फॉलोड, अदरवाइज दैट पर्सनल लिबर्टी that is being taken away, if it is not followed, these procedures are not followed, then that will be a violation. So if anybody is arrested, he shall be told the grounds for his arrest, he shall have the right to have a lawyer of his own choice, and he shall be produced before the nearest magistrate within 24 hours. Next is the right against exploitation. Under this, we have two articles, Article 23 and Article 24. Ab, there are many types of exploitation, jaise ki forced labor. Kisi se kaam karwa lena, but payment na karna. So, forced labor is without payment, beggar, without payment. So, this is exploitation. Or the second type of exploitation is buying and selling of human beings, as we say, human trafficking. So these kind of exploitations, they are prohibited under the Constitution, under this article. So this article, it prohibits beggar or forced labor without payment. It prohibits buying and selling of human beings and using them as slaves. So this kind of exploitation is prohibited under this article. Also, the Constitution states that the children who are below the age of 14 years, they cannot be employed in dangerous jobs or dangerous factories and mines, जैसे कि glass making factory. तो ऐसे जो dangerous factories हैं, mines हैं, उनमें वो children who are below the age of 14 years, they cannot be employed. That means जो Children who are below the age of 14 year, वो dangerous में नहीं employ हो सकते, but उसके इलावा जैसे कि household labor, वहाँ पे they can be employed. So it prohibits only the employment of age of employment of children below the age of 14 years in dangerous jobs like factories and mines. With child labor being made illegal and right to education becoming a fundamental right for children, this right against exploitation has become more meaningful. Next is right to freedom of religion. Article 25, 26, 27 and 28, they come under right to freedom of religion. Now, India mein we have the right of freedom of religion. That means we have freedom of conscience, freedom to profess, freedom to practice and propagate our religion. First of all, freedom of conscience. Freedom of religion ke under we have been given these rights, and first is freedom of conscience. So first of all, conscience means having the inner freedom. That means you have the right to choose your own religion. And at the same time, if you do not want to follow any religion, agar your inner conscience or your inner freedom says that no, I don't want to follow any religion, so that is freedom of conscience. So you have this freedom under this article. Second is freedom to profess. Profess ka matlab hota hai jaise ki mantra japna. So you can profess मंत्र जपना आपको अलाउड है, दिस इज योर फ्रीडम. नेक्स्ट इज फ्रीडम टू प्रैक्टिस, जैसे कि माला फेरना, या फिर सिख लोग दे वेयर किरपान, सो दैट इज प्रैक्टिसिंग देयर रिलीजन. नेक्स्ट इज प्रोपिगेटिंग, प्रोपिगेट का मतलब होता है स्प्रेडिंग इंफॉर्मेशन रिगार्डिंग योर रिलीजन, सो दिस इज प्रोपिगेटिंग योर रिलीजन. तो यू हैव अ फ्रीडम ऑफ कंसाइंस, यू कैन चूज एनी रिलीजन, यू हैव अ फ्रीडम टू प्रोफेस, आप पाठ कर सकते हो, आप जो भी मंत्र जप सकते हो, सो दैट इज प्रोफेसिंग योर रिलीजन. नेक्स्ट इज प्रैक्टिस, माला फेरना, किरपान पहनना, ऑल दिस इज प्रैक्टिसिंग योर रिलीजन. एंड नेक्स्ट इज प्रोपिगेट इज spreading information, telling the other people about your religion, that is propagating your religion. So all these rights come under freedom of religion. But this freedom to religion, obviously it has certain limitations. Your religious rights, freedom of religion can be restricted on grounds of public order, morality and health. इसको एक एग्जाम्पल से समझते हैं. जैसे आपके जो साथ वाला घर है वहां पे जगराता चल रहा है, सो ऑब्वियसली एक लाउड वॉइस आ रही है, एंड उसके जो साथ वाला घर है वहां पे कोई हार्ट पेशेंट रहते हैं, सो दैट हार्ट पेशेंट ऑन द ग्राउंड ऑफ हेल्थ जो ये वाला घर है उनको रोका जा सकता है फ्रॉम डूइंग दैट जगराता. सो क्योंकि वो हार्ट पेशेंट है, उनकी इतने लाउड वॉइस से ही कैन हिज हेल्थ कैन डिटीरियोरेट. सो ऑन दोज काइंड ऑफ ग्राउंड्स दिस फ्रीडम ऑफ रिलीजन कैन बी टेकन अवे, दे कैन बी स्टॉप्ड फ्रॉम डूइंग दैट जगराता. सो पब्लिक ऑर्डर, मोरालिटी एंड हेल्थ के ग्राउंड्स पे दिस राइट कैन बी रिस्ट्रिक्टेड. सो दिस इज नॉट एन अनलिमिटेड राइट. Also, another example is a sati. So earlier sati, it was an important part of the Hindu religion. But because this was a social evil, we know that sati, it was against various, you know, it was not good. So it was restricted that sati, it was abolished by the government. So आप ये नहीं कह सकते कि हमारा जो हिंदू रिलीजन है उसके हमारी जो रिलीजन राइट है दैट हैज बीन टेकन अवे. नो, बिकॉज राइट टू रिलीजन इज नॉट एन अनलिमिटेड राइट. सो इन ऑर्डर टू रूट आउट द सोशल इविल्स दैट सती प्रैक्टिस दैट वाज स्टॉप्ड और बैंड बाय द गवर्नमेंट, सो दिस इज हाउ वेरियस रिस्ट्रिक्शंस कैन बी इम्पोज्ड ऑन फ्रीडम ऑफ रिलीजन. Now we said that we have a freedom to propagate. That means we can tell other people about our religion. So this does not mean that you can force other people to convert to your religion. So right to propagate is just about spreading the information about your religion and not forcing anybody to convert to your religion. So it is only about spreading information about your religion and attracting others towards your religion and not forcible conversions. नेक्स्ट इज कल्चरल एंड एजुकेशनल राइट्स. अब पिछली राइट्स में हमने रिलीजियस राइट्स के बारे में पढ़ा. नाउ इंस्टेड ऑफ दीज कुछ और तरह की राइट्स होती हैं, जैसे कि कल्चर प्रोटेक्ट करने की, लैंग्वेज प्रोटेक्ट करने की. नाउ देर आर वेरियस माइनॉरिटीज जिनका कुछ अलग कल्चर है, हु हैव डिफरेंट कल्चर, डिफरेंट लैंग्वेजेस. सो उन माइनॉरिटीज को, उन कल्चरल एंड लिंग्विस्टिक माइनॉरिटीज को राइट है कि वो अपना ये जो कल्चर है वो प्रोटेक्ट कर सके. सो राइट ऑफ द माइनॉरिटीज टू मेंटेन देयर कल्चर. This minority right can be based on the language, उनकी जो linguistic language है उनकी, that is वो बहुत ही कम population है जो उस language को use करती है, so they become linguistic minority, या फिर उनका culture बहुत ही different है, so linguistic and cultural minorities come under this right. So in order to protect their culture, they can set up their own educational institution. So this is cultural and educational rights. But फंडामेंटल राइट्स एज वी ऑलरेडी डिस्कस्ड दे आर नॉट एब्सोल्यूट इन नेचर, कुछ लिमिट्स हैं उसके ऊपर. एक लिमिट तो हमने राइट टू रिलीजन के अंडर ही देख ली, जो कि ग्राउंड्स है पब्लिक ऑर्डर, हेल्थ, मोरालिटी, वो जगराता वाला जो एग्जाम्पल है कि उस तरह की लिमिट्स रिस्ट्रिक्शंस हैं हमारी फंडामेंटल राइट्स के ऊपर. दूसरी जैसे कि फ्रीडम टू असेंबली, ये भी करंट एग्जाम्पल से वी कैन अंडरस्टैंड दिस. जैसे कि जब अब तो फिर भी खुल गया है लॉकडाउन, पहले जब देर वॉज दिस रिसेंट लॉकडाउन वॉज इम्पोज्ड, it was not allowed, freedom of assembly was not allowed, people were not allowed to assemble at one place. ye to basically freedom of assembly was taken away. now that was done on the grounds of health again. covid ki jo requirement hai, so people has to maintain some distance, so on those grounds freedom of assembly was restricted few months back. to is tarah ki kuch restrictions hai jo hamari fundamental rights ke exercise ke upar lagai ja sakti hain. Now, last right is right to constitutional remedies. अब हमने सारी rights पढ़ ली, right to equality, right to life, right to freedom of religion. Now, what if these rights are violated? तो हमारे पास क्या option है? Under this right to constitutional remedies, हमारे पास ये right है कि अगर हमारी कोई भी राइट वायोलेट होती है, अगर हमारा फ्रीडम ऑफ रिलीजन हमसे छीन लिया जा रहा है ऑन सम अनरीजनेबल ग्राउंड्स, या फिर हमारे बाकी फ्रीडम्स है, फ्रीडम ऑफ स्पीच एंड एक्सप्रेशन इज बीइंग टेकन अवे फ्रॉम अस, अंडर दिस राइट टू कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल रेमिडीज वी हैव द राइट टू अप्रोच सुप्रीम कोर्ट और हाई कोर्ट, एंड वी कैन take this issue that our fundamental rights are being violated. So we have been given the authority to approach High Court or Supreme Court in case our fundamental rights are violated. So that is why Dr. B.R. Ambedkar, he said that this right is the heart and soul of the Constitution. वो इसलिए बोला क्योंकि अगर ये राइट ही नहीं होती, अगर हमें सिर्फ फंडामेंटल राइट्स ही मिल जाती और ये राइट मिलती नहीं, तो फिर उन फंडामेंटल राइट्स की एग्जिस्टेंस का भी कोई कोई फायदा नहीं था, क्योंकि इन केस वो राइट्स वायोलेट होती हमारे पास कुछ ऑप्शन ही नहीं होता. ये होता कि बस हमें राइट्स दे दी और हमें ये नहीं बताया गया व्हाट टू डू इफ दीज राइट्स आर टेकन अवे फ्रॉम अस. दैट इज व्हाई दिस राइट इज सेड एज द heart and soul of the constitution by Dr. B.R. Ambedkar. Ab we can approach Supreme Court and High Court. Now when we will approach Supreme Court and High Court, so Supreme Court and High Courts, they can issue various writs in order to protect our fundamental rights. Writ ka matlab hota hai koi bhi ek formal order issue karna. So is article ke under there are five types of writs which can be issued by the courts. The first writ is writ of habeas corpus. Habeas corpus ka literal meaning hota hai produce the body. तो इन केस किसी भी पर्सन को इलीगली डिटेन किया गया है, इलीगली अरेस्ट किया गया है, सो इफ दिस इज द केस देन द कोर्ट कैन इशू अ रिट ऑफ हेबियस कॉर्पस. अ कोर्ट कैन ऑर्डर दैट दिस पर्सन हैज टू बी ब्रॉट बिफोर इट प्रोड्यूस द बॉडी, सो दिस इज द रिट ऑफ हेबियस कॉर्पस. इफ एनी पर्सन इज अरेस्टेड आर्बिट्रेरीली देन द कोर्ट कैन इशू दिस रिट. नेक्स्ट इज रिट ऑफ मैंडमस. मैंडमस का मतलब होता है वी कमांड. अगर कोई भी पब्लिक अथॉरिटी, सपोज आप अपना लाइसेंस बनवाने जा रहे हो और वो जो पब्लिक अथॉरिटी है जिसने आपका लाइसेंस बनवाना है वो अपना काम नहीं कर रही है, सो यू कैन अप्रोच द कोर्ट एंड द कोर्ट विल कमांड दैट पब्लिक अथॉरिटी टू डू देयर वर्क. सो दिस रिट इज इशूड वेन द कोर्ट फाइंड दैट अ पर्टिकुलर ऑफिस होल्डर इज नॉट डूइंग लीगल ड्यूटी एंड देयर बाय इंफ्रिंजिंग द राइट ऑफ द इंडिविजुअल. तो मैंडमस के अंडर कोर्ट कमांड कर सकती है. मैंडमस मीन्स वी कमांड. नेक्स्ट इज रिट ऑफ प्रोहिबिशन. अब ये प्रोहिबिशन वी विल अंडरस्टैंड विद सर्शरारी. First we let's discuss quo warranto. So the third writ is writ of quo warranto. Quo warranto ka literal meaning hota hai by what authority. Now suppose aap college mein ho aur aapke jo college ke director hain उनकी जो पोजीशन है उसकी ये रिक्वायरमेंट है दैट दैट पोजीशन कैन बी हेल्ड बाय एनी पर्सन हु इज लेस देन द एज ऑफ 65 इयर्स. नाउ सपोज अब आपके जो डायरेक्टर हैं उनकी टर्म खत्म हो चुकी है, ही इज एक्सीडिंग, या तो उनकी टर्म खत्म हो चुकी है या फिर उनकी एज ज्यादा हो चुकी है, अबव 65 हो चुकी है. सो दैट मीन्स ही कैनॉट होल्ड दैट पोस्ट नाउ, ही शुड लीव दैट पोस्ट नाउ. बट इन केस वो ये पोस्ट नहीं छोड़ रहे हैं, then writ of quo warranto can be issued by the court. The court can ask that director that by what authority are you holding this post? You are not eligible to hold this post. So this is writ of quo warranto. If a court finds that a person is holding office but is not entitled to hold that office, it issues the writ of quo warranto and restricts that person from acting as an office holder. Now, writ of certiorari. अब एक है writ of prohibition और एक है writ of certiorari. First, let's discuss writ of certiorari. Now, under this writ of certiorari, Supreme Court या फिर High Courts, they can review the orders of the lower courts. वो review कर सकते हैं कि कहीं lower courts का जो order है वो illegal तो नहीं है, कहीं लोअर कोर्ट ने अपनी ज्यूरिसडिक्शन से बाहर जाके तो कोई ऑर्डर नहीं दे दिया. सो सुप्रीम कोर्ट्स और हाई कोर्ट्स दे रिव्यू द ऑर्डर ऑफ द लोअर कोर्ट्स एंड इन केस दे फाइंड दैट द लोअर कोर्ट्स दे हैव इलीगली या फिर उन्होंने अपनी ज्यूरिसडिक्शन के बाहर जाके कोई केस देखा है, देन जो ऑर्डर आया था उस केस का इट कैन बी क्वेश्ड अंडर दिस रिट ऑफ सर्शरारी. सो This is writ of certiorari. Now writ of prohibition. Prohibition का मतलब होता है to prohibit, to forbid. तो उस writ के अंदर भी जो higher courts या supreme court है वो prohibit करते हैं lower court को against discussing any courts that is not under their jurisdiction. The only difference is that certiorari में already case decide हो चुका है, तो उस कोर्ट का जो डिसीजन, जो कोर्ट ने डिसीजन दिया है वो डिसीजन को क्वैश किया जाता है, उस कोर्ट का जो ऑर्डर है, क्योंकि केस सुन चुका है वो कोर्ट, उसने ऑर्डर दे दिया है तो ऑर्डर को क्वैश कर दिया जाता है, कैंसिल कर दिया जाता है. बट प्रोहिबिशन के अंडर अभी ऑर्डर नहीं आया है, इट इज दैट कि अभी पूरा केस सुना नहीं गया है, कोई ऑर्डर नहीं आया है, उससे पहले ही हाई कोर्ट ने या फिर सुप्रीम कोर्ट ने प्रिवेंट कर दिया उस कोर्ट को फ्रॉम लिसनिंग दैट केस. सो दिस इज द डिफरेंस बिटवीन रिट ऑफ प्रोहिबिशन एंड रिट ऑफ सर्शरारी. सर्शरारी में के मतलब एक तरह से एंड तक जा चुका है केस, बट प्रोहिबिशन में अभी केस स्टार्ट हुआ है, कोई ऑर्डर नहीं आया है. सो दिस वॉज अबाउट राइट टू कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल रेमिडीज. सो दिस इज अबाउट फंडामेंटल राइट्स. आई होप इट इज क्लियर टू यू ऑल. थैंक यू.